Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta, as your mathematics teacher. Today we will discuss some more examples based on principle of mathematical induction. I request to everyone, if you still not watch my first video, so please watch my first video because we already discussed what is PMI and what are the steps that we have to follow to prove a question which is based on PMI, and what's the main benefit why we are study PMI. All such type of concept we already discussed in our first lecture, so please watch my first lecture. Now we are going to take some more problem, and again request to please watch my this video very carefully, because I'm going to take so many questions which are very interesting, and you have to learn how you can prove. It's very interesting because these questions all based on principle of mathematical induction, which is based on reasoning. So we have to find out the reason to how we prove such a relations. So PMI, again I revise, PMI means principle of mathematical induction. This type of reasoning basically gives an idea how we check the mathematical statement. Is such mathematical statement is true for every number? So I'm right here a statement 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube and so on up to n cube. I'm taking last number is your n and starting from 1. So it means I'm dealing with only natural numbers. So we know the natural numbers start from 1 to n, and we have to check if this relation holds true for every values of natural number. Then is it possible to check is it this relation is true or not for every values of n? Then the answer will be no, because if I take 1, I can check the relation. If I take n is equal to 2, it means we are taking 2 terms, then is it possible to calculate? Similarly, we can 3, 4, 5 up to 10 at most, because if the number goes to 1000, 1 lakh, 1 crore, then is it not possible to check this validity of a statement. So we have to use another approach to check the validity of a mathematically statement. So PMI gives an alternate approach to check the validity of a mathematically statement. This is the main reason why we are studying the PMI, because this chapter is basically based on the reasoning. So we have to find the reason, what the reason behind it this relation is exist. So we have totally based on our imagination, and we have to prove and we have to calculate the reason why this is true. So in this type we have to prove the questions. We have to take 3 steps. Our first step is n is equal to 1. We have to put n is equal to 1 in our mathematical statement, and if this statement is true, then we have to take any other number. So in this we have to take arbitrary values. I am choosing here n is equal to k. K is your any arbitrary number between 1 to n, maybe any number. If such statement is valid, again I repeat, if such statement is valid or true, then the next statement n is equal to k plus 1 will also be true. If it is true, it means we take assume n is equal to k, our statement is true. And if we will prove n is equal to k plus 1 statement is also true, then the question is our proof. So that statement will hold to the all natural values. So these are the three steps that we have to follow and to prove any questions. Now I am again taking the same steps so that you can clarify your basic concept how we again prove the question based on PMI. First, to taking our step 1, put n is equal to 1 in our first statement. So I am taking p of 1. So put n is equal to 1. N is equal to 1 means we are taking only one terms. These are up to n terms, so we have to consider only one term, and one term is only first, that is equal to 1 cube. So our left hand side is equal to 1 cube, and 1 cube gives the result 1. It means we get our left hand side is equal to 1. Now we have to check our right hand side also. And what will be the right hand side? This is our right hand side, and we have to put n is equal to 1 into the right hand side. So put our right hand side is this, and we have to put n is equal to 1. So if we put n is equal to 1, what we will got? 1 plus 1 divided by 2 whole square. If we solve them, what we will got? 1. 1 plus 1, 2, and 2 divided by 2, which is equal to 1, and square of 1 is equal to 1. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side. We proved for n is equal to k, n is equal to 1. This statement is valid. Left hand side becomes is equal to right hand side. So LHS is equal to RHS. Now this is our step 1. Put n is equal to 1. Now we have to take our next step. We have to choose arbitrary number k. Step 2. Let n is equal to k. The statement is true. Let statement is true. We are assumed here this statement is true. So in this we have to put n is equal to k, where we will found n, substitute n is equal to k. This is our first statement. Now put n is equal to k in equation 1. What we will got? P of k, this is your 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube up to plus k cube is equal to k into k plus 1 divided by 2 whole square. This is our second equation. We have to use this equation and prove the third equation, left hand side is equal to right hand side. So firstly keep in mind, whenever we write our last term, so firstly we have to write first term before the last term. If suppose this is your 3 cube, and you can easily calculate what will be the first term before it, that is 2, 3 minus 1. So see here, if we calculate the first term before the n cube, and what will be the terms? Naturally n minus 1, and it is in terms of cube, then that term will becomes n minus 1 whole cube. So this becomes n minus 1 whole cube. So we can also put here, we are putting n is equal to k, then we get k minus 1 whole cube. Or you can say that the term before k cube is k minus 1 whole cube, because the last term is k, then before the k is k minus 1 and whole cube. So it comes also in cube. So this is our second statement, and this statement is very important because the whole concept is based on this statement. So I request to everyone, please put it in a block so that we can use, and we are our mind totally focus on equation number 2. This is our second step. Now we have to take our third step, and we have to take next value of this statement. If this statement will be true, then the next statement also be true, that we have to prove that. So now we have to put n is equal to k plus 1 in equation first. So put in equation 1, n is equal to k plus 1. Step 3. To prove for n is equal to k plus 1. Statement is true. Means we have to focus on to prove our third equation, and we can use the result of equation 2 because this statement is our assumed true. So put it n is equal to k plus 1 in equation number first, then what we will put? P of k plus 1 is equal to 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus up to here we have to put k plus 1. So we have replaced n is equal to k plus 1 and this minus will come as it is, all cube plus here k plus 1 whole cube, and this becomes n is replaced by k plus 1, and this n is replaced by k plus 1, and this plus 1 as it is divided by 2 whole square. It means our main focus is to make left hand side is equal to right hand side. So please simplify it so that we can take left hand side and make it as equal to right hand side. So we can simplify and we can rewrite as k plus 1 as it is, and this is k plus 1 plus 1 which is equal to k plus 2. So we can write it k plus 2 divided by 2 whole square. This is our right hand side. It means we have to prove this, and our left hand side is this. So we focus on this, our left hand side, and make it as equal to right hand side. So first we simplify this. What we will got? 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus. This is 1 cancel out with 1, but we will got only k. K cube plus k plus 1 whole cube. Now please compare it with your equation second. What will be the 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to last term is your k cube, and this term is equal to k into k plus 1 divided by 2 whole square. And now compare it. This is same. So substituting the value from the equation 2, put it here. Substituting this value from equation 2, we have to substitute this value from the equation number 2. What we will got? K into k plus 1 divided by whole square. So I got this portion, so please make a note first. Then I'm writing, because 1 plus 2 plus q up to k cube has value is equal to k into k plus 1, so we can write it is here k into k plus 1 divided by 2 whole square. I write only this value, and plus k plus 1 whole cube we have to write as it is. So I am writing this term as it is, plus k plus 1 whole cube. We can write also as, if we square both the equation terms, we get k square k plus 1 whole square, and square of 2 is equal to 4, which is equal to plus k plus 1 whole cube. Now we can take LCM. What we will quote? LCM is 4. We get k square k plus 1 whole square plus 4 into k plus 1 whole cube. Please make a note first. So solve it. in this we can take common k plus 1 whole square, because this comes in both the terms. So we are taking common k plus 1 whole square. K plus 1 whole square, I am taking common. What I will got? Here I will got k square, and here I will got 4 into k plus 1. The whole divided by 4. Now solve it. K plus 1 whole square into k square plus multiply this 4k plus 4 divided by 4 and compare it this. What it is? Simply k plus 2 whole square. If we solve it, what we will get? A square plus b square plus 2ab, which is equal to k square plus me 4 plus me 4k. So we can write as k plus 1 whole square, k plus 2 whole square, and 4 can also be write as 2 square. So all the 3 terms are in form of square. So we can take all the terms and taking only 1 square. K plus 1, k plus 2 divided by 2 whole square. This is our left hand side. Now you have to check. This is your left hand side and this is your right hand side. Both the terms are equal. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side. Hence prove. So we prove. So please make a note first. So now I am going to take our next question. This is 1 upon me 1 multiply 3 plus 1 upon me 3 multiply 5 and so on. The sum of these types of term is equal to n divided by 2n plus 1. It means you get another relations. And please make a look fast, because here you have to look 1 into 3. 1 into 3 is basically 2 odd number. 1 into 3. Next one is 3 into 5. Next, again 2 odd number. Means we have to take a pair of consecutive odd number starting from 1. 1 into 3, then 3 into 5, then 5 into 7, and so on. So if you calculate the sum, but it is in form of reciprocals, then the relation is equal to n upon me 2n plus 1. So we have to again check this statement is as valid or not. We have to take all the steps are same. So we proceed to our solving process. Our step 1. Put n is equal to 1. Our left hand side is, because we are putting only 1, it means we have to take only first term. Our first term is only 1 upon me 1 multiply 3. 1 upon me 1 multiply 3, which is equal to 1. 1 into 3. See, our left hand side is equal to 1 by 3. Now put right hand side. N is equal to 1 divided by 2 into 1 plus 1, which is equal to 1. 2 into 1, 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3. So in this, left hand side is equal to right hand side. This statement is true, for n is equal to 1. Now we have to take n is equal to k. Step 2, put n is equal to k. The statement becomes p of k is equal to 1 upon me 1 into 3 plus 1 upon me 3 into 5 plus up to last term is what? 1 upon me 2 into k minus 1 into 2 into k plus 1, which is equal to k 2 into k plus 1. And this is our first equation, and this becomes our second equation. And this equation is important, so I draw it in rectangular box. This is our assumed truth. Now we have to take our next step, third step, n is equal to k plus 1. Step 3, put n is equal to k plus 1. To prove truth, it means we have to prove it is true for k plus 1 also. So put it in our first equation, p of k plus 1, which is equal to 1 upon 1 into 3 plus 1 upon 3 into 5 plus our last term is 1 upon 2 into. Firstly, we have to write first term before the last term. Then please think what will be the first term before this term. Please make a look first. Then what's the term? As we already discussed, our last term is your n. So before the last term is n minus 1. It means if we have to calculate the first term before this term, then what will be the term? N minus 1. So put it here. What we will got? Our last term is 2 into n. So we have to put n minus 1. N minus 1 minus 1. And this becomes 2 into n minus 1 plus 1. Now solve this. 1 upon me. 2 into n, 2n minus 2 minus 2, 1. And this is 2n minus 2 plus 1. This is equal to 2n minus 3 and 2n minus 1. So put it here. n minus 3 and 2n minus 1. So please make a look first. So start first term, second term, n2, last term is of this. Put n is equal to k plus 1. 2 into n k plus 1 minus 3 minus 3 into into 2 into n k plus 1 minus 1 plus our last term is here 1 upon 2 into k plus 1 minus 1 into 2 into k plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to, what's the right hand side? We have to also put n is equal to k plus 1 divided by 2 into k plus 1 plus 1. So firstly you have to simplify your right hand side, and what we will got, I am solving here k plus 1 as it is, divide by multiply this 2 into k 2k plus 2 into 1 2 plus 1, which is equal to k plus 1 divided by 2k plus 3. This is our right hand side. It means we have to prove this. So now I am taking our left hand side and goes to the right hand side. So if I solve this, 1 upon me 1 into 3 plus 1 upon me 3 into 5 plus up to plus. If we solve this, what we will got? If we solve this, we got 2k plus 2. And this is minus 3, and this 2k plus 2 minus 1 plus this term, what will be 1 divided by. So please make a note first, then I will solve it here. Please make a note first. So now I am solving it here. Our first term is left hand side 1 divided by 1 multiply 3 plus 1 upon 3 multiply 5 plus up to plus this. If we solve this, what we will get? 2 into k 2k plus 2 into 1 2. It means we get 2k plus 2 and this minus 3. Into this 2k plus 2 minus 1 और नेक्स्ट टर्म इज दिस, वन अकाउन में 2k प्लस 2, 2k प्लस 2 माइनस 1 इनटू 2k प्लस 2, 2k प्लस 2 प्लस 1. नाउ सॉल्व दिस, 1 अपॉन में 1 इनटू 3 प्लस 1 अपॉन में 3 इनटू 5 प्लस अप टू प्लस 1 अपॉन में दिस वन इज 2k, 2 माइनस 3 व्हिच इज इक्वल टू माइनस 1, 2k माइनस 1 एंड दिस बिकम 2k, 2 माइनस 1 प्लस 1 प्लस 1 अपॉन में 2k, 2 माइनस 1 प्लस 1 दिस ही बिकम्स 2k, 2 प्लस 1 व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 3. नाउ कंपेयर इट, द होल टर्म इज सेम, इज सेम, सो सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस वैल्यू फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन नंबर 2. सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग दिस वैल्यू फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन 2, दिस टर्म इज इक्वल टू k इंटू डिवाइड बाई 2k प्लस 1. सो राइट हियर, k डिवाइड बाई 2k प्लस 1 वी रिप्लेस बाय दिस टू होल टर्म k अपॉन में 2k प्लस 1. नाउ दिस प्लस 1 एज इट इज एंड दिस टर्म एज इट इज, 1 अपॉन में 2k प्लस 1 इंटू 2k प्लस 3. नाउ वी हैव टू सॉल्व दिस एंड मेक इट एज ए राइट हैंड साइड. सो आई एम रबिंग दिस, प्लीज मेक अ नोट फर्स्ट. So solve it. We take an LCM of 2k plus 1 and 2k plus 3. In this we have 2k plus 1, not 2k plus 3. So it will be multiplied with your k. Multiply with 2k square plus my 3k plus my 1. Now factorize it. 2k square plus में 3k plus में 1. What will be the factor? 2k square plus में 2k plus k plus 1. We take common 2k, k plus 1. Again I am taking common 1, k plus 1. So here k plus 1 again take common. We got 2k plus 1. So put it here. We got k plus 1 into 2k plus 1 upon me 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3. This will be cancel out and we get k plus 1 divided by 2k plus 3. This is our left hand side and this is our right hand side. So left hand side becomes right hand side. We prove our question. Make a note first. So be ready. Now we are taking our next type of question, which becomes somewhat difficult as first. In our first type of question, we have to give a identity or a statement, which is equal statement. But today we are taking a statement which is inequality, either to be greater or less, but not equal. Please read the statement. In this we have to prove 2 raised to power n is greater than n for every values or positive values of integer. It means our statement is this, 2 raised to power n is greater than n. It's not an equality statement. Then how we prove? Because such type of question totally based on your reasoning, your imagination power. So you have to do something imagination to prove such type of relations. Now how we can prove? So please make a look very carefully, because this type of question becomes very somewhat difficult. So what we have to follow? Our step 1, let n is equal to 1 to check the validity of the statement. Put, this is our statement p of n. So if we put 1, we get 2 raised to power 1 is greater than 1 because we have to put n is equal to 1. If you put n is equal to 1, we get this as 2 is greater than 1. For always 2, it is true. Now go to second step. Assume true. Let n is equal to k. Then what we will got? We got 2 raised to the power k is greater than k. This is our first equation, and this becomes our second equation. This is very important equation because the whole concept is totally based on this equation. We have to use this to prove our third statement. What will be our third statement? This is our step 2. Now I am going to test step 3. Put n is equal to k plus 1 to be proved. Truth. We have to prove truth this. Then how we can do prove this? So substitute this 2 into k plus 1, because we have to put k is n is equal to k plus 1. That's why I am putting n is equal to k plus 1. So 2 raised to power k plus 1 is greater than k plus 1, which we have to be prove. It means we have to prove this, we have to focus this. And whenever such type of question is asked you, you have to prove this, but you have to take this, because this statement is already truth because you are assuming. So we take such concept and take our equation 2, change into the equation 3. According to equation 3, we have to change our statement 2. Please keep in mind. So how we do? As power k is greater than k, it is true, k is greater than k, it is true, it is assumed true. Now change this equation as compared to with third equation. In this we have to take, and the term comes in the form of 2 raised to power k plus 1. Then how we take this term and change into this term? If we multiply both sides 2, we get our left hand side. How we get? Multiply by this. Multiply by 2. Both sides. Multiply by 2. What we get? 2 into 2 raised to power k is greater than 2 into k, because we are multiplying 2 to the both side. Now base are same and the power of 2 is here 1, then power will be add. It becomes 2 raised to the power k plus 1 is greater than 2k. We can write as, again our left hand side becomes, but we have to change it also in terms of right hand side. Then what we have to do? As it implies 2 raised to power k plus 1 is greater than, we can write 2k as k plus 1, k plus k. We can write as, now we have to prove this statement, but this will be not your right hand side. Then what we have to do? As we already discussed, as k is greater than 1, because first we have to put n is equal to 1, then we have to take another 1. So naturally that k value is other than 1, and other than 1, what's the natural number is? Greater than 1. So always k is greater than 1. So I write k is greater than 1. If I am adding k on both sides, then what I will get? adding k on both side. What I will quote? K plus k is greater than 1 plus k. I will quote. Now compare it. K plus k is greater than 1 plus k. I am taking this equation as a third, and this take as equation number 4. As 2k plus 1 is greater than k plus k, and this k plus k is greater than 1 plus k, so we can write all over 2k plus 1 is greater than k plus k from here, and k plus k is greater than 1 plus k, or you can say that k plus 1. Clearly, so by this, what we will got? We will got 2k plus 1 is greater than our k plus 1. Please make a note first, then I will take it again. I am taking again such example because such a question is something difficult. So I am again to explain you what's the reason and how you can differentiate this becomes, or this is greater than this term. How we can proceed? Firstly, you have to take all the three steps and note in such a manner. Step 1, put n is equal to 1. P of 1 is equal to ratio 2 raised to power 1 greater than 1. It means 2 is greater than 1. This statement is true. Now take second step. Step true. Assume truth. Put n is equal to k. Then what we will got? We got 2 raised to power k is greater than k. This is your first equation, and this one our second equation. Now what we have to prove? Our step third. To prove true for n is equal to k plus 1, then the statement becomes 2 raised to power k plus 1 greater than n is equal to k plus 1. It means we have to prove this. These are the three steps, and how we prove, please watch very carefully. Because this statement is already true, so we take this statement, and the main point, keep in mind, we have to change second statement in terms of our third statement. So we have to make second statement to our third statement. So whatever the steps required to make it in terms of, or change it in terms of third, you can do that. Either multiply on both sides, either divide on both sides, either adding both sides, or either subtracting on both sides. So you have to do all the steps. But you have to keep in mind, you have to change your second equation in terms of third equations. So we are taking our second equation as 2 raised to power k is greater than k. This statement is true. Now compare it. K plus 1, how we will get k plus 1? If we multiply by 2. Because if the base are same, then power will be added, and we get 2 raised to power k plus 1. So our first step is to multiply by 2 on both sides. Multiply by 2 on both sides. So we are multiplying by 2 on both sides. Then what we will go? 2 into 2 raised to the power k1, 2 into k. Now base is same, power will be added, and the power of 2 is here 1. We got 2 raised to the power k plus 1 is greater than 2k. As we can quote our left hand side is equal to left hand side. Now change according to our right hand side. Then what we have to do? Now 2k can be written as k plus k. K written as we can write as k plus k. And please keep in mind, k is our any integer. K is any integer. Because we have to choose for n is equal to 1, then the value of k must be greater than 1, because we take already n is equal to 1 and we have to take any integer, or you can select positive integer, and its value should be greater than 1. This is the necessary condition. And now we have to take in terms of this, we have to change this in terms of this. What we have to add? We are adding k on both sides. Adding k on both sides. If we add k on both sides, what will we call? K plus k is greater than 1 plus k. We can write as. Now compare this. This is our third equation and this is our fourth equation. Now look at this. Firstly, a is 4. I am taking an example. A is 4. B is 3 and C is 2. So here I can write as A is greater than B. True, because 4 is greater than 3. And now I can write it. B is greater than C. I can write because 3 is greater than 2. If we combine this, then what I just said, A is always greater than C. Because 4 is greater than 2. Again I repeat, here I am taking A is equal to 4, B is equal to 3 and C is equal to 2. And A is 4, A is greater than B because 4 is greater than 3. And B is greater than C because 3 is greater than 2. So we can see that 4 is greater than 2, it means A is greater than C. The whole concept we apply the same here. This term A, this is B, B is same and this is C. So we can compare it. What we will call? We compare in this manner. Please make a note first. So this is your A, this one is your B, this one is your B and this is your C. This is A is greater than B. And this indicate B is greater than C. So we can see that A is greater than C. So we can write 2k plus 1 is greater than C is 1 plus k, or you can write as k plus 1 also. So please make a note first. So from 3 equation and 4 equation, what we write as 2 raised to the power k plus 1 is greater than k plus k, and k plus k is greater than 1 plus k, or you can say k plus k 1. So we also write here 2k plus 1 is greater than k plus 1, and this is our right hand side that we have to prove. So hence prove. So please make a note first, then I will take another question of such type of question. Please do hard, because such a question is typical to understand. So now I am going to take another example similar to as first. But it say, if your p and your statement is a statement 2 raised to power n is greater than 3 times n, and if the pk is true, as we already given, pk statement is true, so there is no need to prove for n is equal to 1, because this statement for k is already true. So we have to start from p of k is true. Now show that p of k plus 1 is also true. It means what we have given. We have given. Statement P of k 2 raised to the power k, because P of k statement is true, so we have to put n is equal to k. If we put n is equal to k, we get 2 raised to power k is greater than 3 into k. True. This is given. And what we have to prove? To prove P of k plus 1. What it means? We have to put n is equal to k plus 1. 2 raised to power k plus 1 is greater than 3 into n. N is k plus 1. Or we can write it as simple form. 2 raised to power k plus 1 is greater than 3 into k. 3k plus 3 into 1, 3. We have to prove this. The same, all the steps are same. So try to understand and try to do yourself. Prove. As 2 raised to power k is greater than 3k is given, and we have to change it in terms of what we have to prove. We have to prove 2 raised to power k plus 1. Again, we have to find out in terms of k plus 1. And how we will get? If we multiply by 2 on both sides. Multiply by 2 on both side. Multiply 2 into 2 raised to power k is greater than 2 into 3k. 2 into 3k. And what will be the results? 2 raised to power 1, k plus 1 is greater than 2 into 3, 6k. And again, we can write as this, as 2 raised to power k plus 1 is greater than 6k is written as 3k plus 3. 3k plus 3k. This is equation your second. We can write as 6k is equal to 3k plus 3k. Now use the same concept. What if k should be greater than 1? As k is greater than 1. Always, because k is integer and that value must be always greater than 1. Now we have to change it in terms of according to our right hand side. Then what we have to do? We have find 3k. How we multiply 3? We multiply by 3 on both sides. Multiply by 3 both sides. Then what we got? 3k greater than 3. Now we have to change in terms of 3k plus 3k. Now we have to add 3k on both sides. Add 3k on both sides. And what we will got? 3k plus 3k is greater than 3 plus 3k. Now this is our third equation. Again same. A is greater than B. And B is greater than C. And what will be? A is greater than C. From equation 2 and 3, we get 2k plus 1 is greater than 3k plus 3k, which is greater than 3k plus 3k is greater than 3 plus 3k. And which can be finished? 2k plus 1 is greater than 3 plus 3k. And compare it. Compare it with equation first. Here, prove. Because 2k plus 1 is greater than 3k plus 3, we have to prove. And we prove 2k plus 1 is greater than 3k plus 3. That is your desired results. So I hope you like my video. Then I will make our next lecture on some another types of question based on your PMI. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. We will meet to take our next video. For watching my video, thank you once again.